My name is Dan Njoroge. I'm 32 years old. And I'm the director, or rather the CEO and founder of this beautiful company called the Suse Executive. As a company, part of the services that we do are executive corporate transports, wedding cars, we do executive close protection, we do yacht charter, helicopter charter, and we also do motorbike escorts. I started this company with nothing. My first office was a single room, mattress, and a modem. That was in 2013, with no car and no office. And here I am telling myself I'm running an executive car hire company. And in 2013, I registered the name. I just used my friend's car. Most of the times, I used to connect with the owners of the cars. Basically, I used to like be a broker in between. And then I give the cars to these big companies. At some point, there's some clients who would want to know where our offices are. Fortunately, I had a friend that I used to use his office. I had all my things there, all my letterheads, my stamps. So anytime a client comes, I'll role play in that office and pretend like a partnership or something. And then at the end of the day, I'll sign the contract and deliver. The fact that I want to retire at 40, definitely I got the psych and the desire to always do what I do so that I can achieve what I want at a shorter period. I need to have systems that will work such that when that time comes, it's just going to be easy for me. I just want to be a board of director, just sitting somewhere and just signing checks and seeing what's going on and how much money I'm making. You know, I've worked for a bank for 4 years. And when I left banking, I was all out there thinking that, you know what, I got all the knowledge that I got to get another bigger job. But unfortunately, it happened that I didn't get nothing. So I ended up trying to look for hustles to do. And since I was a kid, I had always wanted to be in business. My first kind of business was, I used to sell stationery. But later on found that I was working too hard and yet getting too little. Can you imagine carrying bags of printing papers all from downtown and bringing them? Actually, this building that I am in is where I used to have most of my clients. Then life became too hard. I had to sell everything I had. I couldn't support myself. And then I started living with friends. Your past should not determine anything. You might have come from a background that is poor. You must have come from a background that is not the best. And you want to go somewhere. That should never ever determine where you're going. That business brilliant idea that you have is your biggest capital that you can always have. Apply it and use what you have at any one particular time. Don't ever wish you had more.